Here are the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community.
We begin in Alberta, where Member of Parliament Retchie Valdez, the first Filipina to be elected to Canada's House of Commons, listened as Filipinos from different cities raised their concerns on immigration, healthcare, access to federal funding, and community support. Valdez assured fellow Filipinos that she will be their voice and that she will bring their concerns to Ottawa.
My objective was to understand and learn the needs of the Filipino Canadians right here in this local community so that I can advocate for you in the House of Commons.
Valdez stressed that her being a Filipino is what made her successful.
You matter, your stories matter, and that's the reason why you're a priority.
Let's go to Pasadena, California, where aspiring figure skaters get the chance to be trained by two-time Philippine Olympian Michael Martinez, who is now passing on his knowledge as a coach.
I love coaching ever since, and you know, I get to share what I've learned, my experience, and to see them actually improve in just a short amount of time.
He makes the lesson really fun, and I'm so proud to learn from so many things from him.
This comes as Martinez himself eyes another shot at the Winter Olympics after failing to make the 2022 Games. The 25-year-old Filipino has continued to train despite his training in Russia getting cut short due to the country's ongoing invasion of Ukraine. With day-to-day living expenses in the U.S. skyrocketing, he's looking at other countries to train in. And finally, in entertainment news, in the Terminal List, Chris Pratt deviates from his usual comedic and superhero lead roles to play James Reese, a hardened Navy SEALs commander trying to uncover the truth behind a tragedy that fell upon the men who served under him. The actor had to lose parts of himself to give justice to the role.
It's all about preparation and getting yourself prepared emotionally to be where you need to be on the day. Having a good understanding of the arc of the character and ultimately, you know, relying a lot on great direction from Antoine Fuqua, who early on helped me set the tone by removing various elements of my own personality to reveal the character.
At the show's Hollywood premiere, the cast paid tribute to military veterans.
We do our best to emulate that loyalty and that trust and that bond as best we can. Infused with a little levity.
The Terminal List, based on Jack Carr's novel of the same name, is now available for streaming on Amazon Prime Video.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.